Asian Network.
Before that, though, hate crimes against British Muslims are going unrecorded. One organisation says it's a big problem, but it's not recognised because there's no religious breakdown when it comes to such attacks. Well, now Faith Matters has launched the UK's first helpline to give the government an idea of how bad the situation actually is for many Muslims. Asian Network's Rahila Bano has more.
The youth hanging around the front of my house, two of them throwing bricks. My son was lying down on the couch. He's nearly gonna die. This brick swam through on his head and the glass has just cut his hand.
Sabana Amode's son escaped a potentially serious injury. They were forced to move out of Saffron Lane, a traditionally white working class area of Leicester, to this more racially diverse part of the city, Highfields, after 2 years of constant abuse and vandalism.
जब मैं अकेला बैठ के जब सोचता हूँ तो मेरे हेल्थ के ऊपर बहुत इफेक्ट आता है, मेरा प्रेशर एकदम लो हो जाता है.
Sabana's husband Salim says the stress made him ill. Three people were later convicted of racially aggravated offences. She says they were attacked because they're Muslim and because of a fear of Islam or Islamophobia.
Wearing my Islamic suits, they just laugh at me, they just throwing the stone at me. They ask me lots of time as well, are you Muslim?
Now, police records show that there were 2007 religiously motivated crimes in England, Wales and Northern Ireland last year. But it's unclear just how many of these were committed against Muslims.
There have been a couple of attacks that we've received, predominantly against females with a hijab.
Research by the organisation Faith Matters reveals that only 14 out of 44 police services collect data on Islamophobic incidents. Although the police do record racially motivated and anti-Semitic crime, they're not required by the government to collect data on anti-Muslim incidents.
The biggest thing that's being pushed by those who do not believe that anti-Muslim attacks are taking place is that they say, where is the data?
That's something Director of Faith Matters, Fiaz Mughal, wants to change.
This is the chance for the community to say, let's present the case in terms of the facts, and let somebody collate it and let somebody present it.
He says anyone who thinks they've been targeted because they follow Islam or are mistakenly thought to belong to the faith should use the free 16-hour-a-day helpline to report it.
If there is graffiti outside a mosque, we want to hear about it. If there is verbal abuse that is made against an individual, then we want to hear about it.
Others, like Dr. Leon Musavi, an expert on Islamophobia, say it's an issue which needs to be tackled.
There is a real concern, especially with the rise of the EDL, for example, in England and other similar groups across Europe. It's all related to Islamophobia and it's consistently Muslims that are targeted, and there's a lot of hatred that is often expressed towards Muslims.
Now, the government has set up a task force to identify the scale of the problem and to come up with solutions. The data collected over the next 12 months by Faith Matters will also be passed on to the group.
Lots of Muslim people in this area ask me, we suffer from this kind of situation, and how do you get out from this situation?
But for victims of anti-Muslim attacks like Sabana Amode, well, it's come too late.
And I said, Allah knows, otherwise I just die there.
And the helpline number is 0800 456 1226, or you can go to their website, which is tellmamauk.org.